Hi all, this is Girija, Department of Mathematics. This session is for class 7, subject Mathematics, chapter 4, rational numbers, and the topics are comparing rational numbers and rational numbers between two rational numbers. Learning objectives. Students, at the end of this session, you will be able to identify rational numbers, rational numbers between two rational numbers, and you are able to compare rational numbers. In addition to that, you are able to arrange the rational numbers in ascending order and descending order. Before going to the topic, let me explain what is rational number. Here is the definition for rational number. A set of numbers that can be expressed as P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0, is called rational number. Here, P is numerator and Q is denominator. As they have given that P and Q are integers, P and Q takes negative numbers as well as positive numbers, whichever number it can take, but the condition is Q is not equal to 0. What they have given, the denominator must not be 0. You know very well that when we divide a number by 0, the answer is not defined. That's why the condition is okay. According to this definition, let me give some example. Students, you are able to find this whether it is a rational number or not. The first one is -6/19. Here, numerator is in negative and denominator is in positive number. It can take P and Q are integer. Therefore, it can take negative numbers as well as positive numbers. Therefore, the given number is rational number. It satisfies the condition Q is not equal to 0. Here denominator is not a 0. Therefore, it is a rational number. Let us have another example. 7/0. Is it a rational number? No. Because Q is not equal to 0 is the condition given there. Q is the denominator. Here the denominator takes the value 0. Therefore, this is not a rational number. Another example. 0/17. Is this a rational number? Yes, of course. Because 0 is a numerator. They did not give that condition. Only the denominator should not be 0. Therefore, 0/17 is a rational number. Students, find the numbers between -3 and 0. This is the integer number line, right? You know very well. So, what are the numbers between -3 and 0? -2 and -1. You know very well. Here, we can count the numbers between two integers, right? There are finite number of integers between any two given integers. And to find rational number between two rational number, we have to represent rational number on the number line. You must know this first. Let 3/5 be the number we have to represent on the number line. 3/5 is a positive number. So, positive number lies to the right of 0. Now, 0 is here. Okay. What to do next? We have to divide according to the number of denominator. We have to divide the line according to the number denominator. What is denominator here? 5 is the denominator. You have to draw 5 lines after 0. the fifth line will be 1. This you may understood later. Okay, now what is the number exists after 0 here? Denominator 5 will be common after 0 for every number. Now what will be the numerator? Numerator increase 1 by 1. The first number will be 1 by 5 and the next number will be 2 by 5. Next is 3 by 5, 4 by 5. Here the fifth is 5 by 5. If you divide 5 by 5, you get 1. This is what I told you already. Now, 3 by 5, where is it? It is between 2 by 5 and 4 by 5. Here it is. Now, I ask another question. How many numbers are between 2 by 5 and 4 by 5? If your answer is 3 by 5, it's wrong in rational number. Let us find rational numbers between two rational numbers. Here, the rational numbers are 2 by 5 and 3 by 5. First of all, you have to find equivalent rational number for 2 by 5. If you multiply 10 by 10 with 2 by 5, we get 20 by 50, which is the equivalent rational number for 2 by 5. Likewise, if you multiply 3 by 5 into 10 by 10, we get 30 by 50, which is also equivalent fraction for 3 by 5. Now, how many numbers exist between 20 by 50 and 30 by 50? Denominators are common. Now, you have to see the numerator. What are the numerator? 20 and 30. Between 20 and 30, what are the number exists there? 21, 22, 23, up to 29, right? Likewise, now between 20 by 50 and 30 by 50, the numbers are 21 by 50, 22 by 50, 23 by 50, 24 by 50, 25 by 50, 26 by 50, 27 by 50, 28 by 50 and 29 by 50. The same way, if you multiply 2 by 5 by 100 by 100, you get the equivalent rational number 200 by 500 and also 3 by 5 into 100 by 100, you get 300 by 500. Now, how many numbers exist between 200 and 300? You know very well. Likewise, the numbers between a rational number increases and increases on finding the equivalent fraction for the given number. Therefore, I would like to conclude here. Between any two rational numbers on the number line, there exists infinitely many rational numbers. What is the meaning of the word infinitely? We cannot count the numbers between two rational numbers. Okay. Thus, the set of rational numbers are infinite. Thus, the set of rational numbers are infinite. We cannot count the rational numbers between rational numbers between two rational numbers. Right? You have to find a rational number between two rational numbers. There are two methods. The first one is using midpoint and the second one is using LCM. First, we find using midpoint method. The rational numbers are 1 by 5 and 3 by 5. There is a formula to find midpoint method. Formula is m plus n by 2. Here m and n are rational numbers. We substitute 1 by 5 and 3 by 5 in the place of m plus n. We get this. We have to add these two first and then you have to divide by 2. Okay. We have to simplify inside the bracket first. On simplifying, we get 1 plus 3 by 5. Why we have written 5 once? You may know the rules already, you have studied in fraction. If the denominators are common, you have to write once and you have to add the numerators. Now, if you add 1 plus 3, we get 4 by 5 inside the bracket and this 2 is multiplied with 5. On dividing by common factor, we get the fraction 2 by 5. Therefore, the rational number 2 by 5 exists between 1 by 5 and 3 by 5. Now, let us find using LCM method. Here, another example. 1 by 3 and 3 by 4 are the rational numbers. Here, the denominator differs. In this case, you have to find LCM for the denominators. What are the denominators here? 3 and 4. They are co-prime. What this mean by co-prime? If they have 1 as HCF, then the numbers are called co-prime. There will be no common factor other than 1. So the LCM of 3 and 4 is 12. Now you have to convert both fraction to equivalent fraction of common denominator, same denominator. So first you convert 1 by 3. You have to multiply 1 by 3 into 4 by 4. On multiplying, you get 4 by 12. Why you have multiplied 3 by 4? Because we have to get the common denominator 12 for both the numbers, then only we can find the numbers between these numbers. Next number is 3 by 4. You have to multiply it by 3 by 3 and you get 9 by 12. Now, both the numbers are in common denominator. So, now you have to compare numerator. Numerator is 4 in the first number and 9 in the second number. So, what are the numbers exist between 4 and 9? 5, 6, 7, 8. But what is the question here? Only one rational number between two rational numbers. You have to find only one rational number between this. We can indicate or take any numbers between these two. A rational number between 1 by 3 and 3 by 4 is maybe 5 by 12 or 6 by 12 or 7 by 12 or 8 by 12. Rational number between given pair 3 by 7 and minus 5 by 7. We have to find a rational number between these two numbers. As I have taught you already, we have to draw lines according to the denominator given. Here, the denominators are same. Numbers, one number is in positive and another number is in negative. So, you have to draw lines on both sides of 0. Positive numbers lies to the right of 0. Negative numbers lies to the left of 0. And the number which is to the right side of a given number is greater than to the left side of the number. This you have to keep it in mind always. The number which is in the left side is less than the number which is on the right side to that number. Okay. Now, how many lines should be after 0? That should be according to the denominator. So, there are 7 lines right side. And also, the first number is 1 by 7. As I have told you already, the denominator will be common and the number in the numerator increases by 1. So the numbers are up to 7 by 7. Now on the left side there are also 7 lines. Okay, now the first number will be -1 by 7, and the next -2 by 7, the next number -3 by 7, next one is -4 by 7, next one is -5 by 7, and the next one is -6 by 7, and the final is -7 by 7. Okay, this is last but not a least. When you divide -7 by 7, you get -1. Okay, now what you have to find here? A number between 3 by 7 and -5 by 7. How many numbers are there between 3 by 7 and -5 by 7 in this number line? Here, -4 by 7, -3 by 7, -2 by 7, -1 by 7, 0, 1 by 7, 2 by 7. In the question, they asked a number. You have to mention only one number. As you wish, the number answer varies for everyone. Now I will take 1 by 7 as the answer. You can also take -2 by 7 as answer, or 0, or -1 by 7, likewise. Okay. Compare the rational numbers using the symbols less than or greater. The first sum is 2 by 10, 7 by 10. Here both the numbers are in positive and having same denominator 10. As I have taught you already, the numbers to the right of 0 are 1 by 10, 2 by 10, 3 by 10, 4 by 10, 5 by 10, 6 by 10, 7 by 10, 8 by 10, 9 by 10, 10 by 10 and 11 by 10. On the left, -1 by 10, -2 by 10, -3 by 10. Now you have to indicate the number first. Where is 2 by 10 here? It's here. And where is 7 by 10? It's here. Now, which number is greater? 2 by 10 or 7 by 10? You know very well, the number which is to the right side is greater. Now, which number is on right side and which is on the left side? 2 by 10 is on the left side and 7 is on the right side in the number line. Therefore, 7 by 10 is greater than 2 by 10. This is the answer. The next question is -2 by 30, -7 by 30. Let us mark the numbers on the right side first. Okay, what is the first number will be 1 by 13 because the denominator of the question is 30. So we are writing the numbers according to the denominator. Next one is 2 by 13, 3 by 13, 4 by 13, 5 by 13, 6 by 13, 7 by 13. Now the numbers are arranged to the left side of 0. First number is -1 by 13, next -2 by 13, -3 by 13, -4 by 13, -5 by 13, -6 by 13, -7 by 13. In question, both the numbers are in negative. So both numbers lies to the left of 0. First, we find where is -2 by 13. It's here. Next, -7 by 13 is here. Now, what do you have to do here? What is the question? Have to compare this. Which number is greater? The number which is to the right side is always greater. In this case, both the number are in negative. In negative numbers, the number which is to the right is greater. Now, -2 by 13 is greater than -7 by 13. question. Arrange in ascending order. Minus 4 by 7, comma minus 2 by 7, comma minus 5 by 7 and 0. First, let us mark these numbers in the number line. You know to mark the numbers as they are having common denominator. We have taken 7 as denominator for every numbers. Out to the left side of 0, these are the numbers arranged. Now, first indicate minus 4 by 7. Where is it? It is here. Next number is 2 by 7. It's here. Next one is minus 5 by 7. It's here and 0, final number. Now you have to arrange the given numbers in ascending order. What is ascending order? How to write the numbers from smallest to biggest. The smallest number in this number line is the number which is to the left of every number. Indicated number is smallest. What is the first number to the left is minus 5 by 7, which is less than. What is the next number? Minus 4 by 7. So, minus 5 by 7 is less than minus 4 by 7. Next, which number we have to write here? 2 by 7 or 0? 0 is to the left of 2 by 7. So, the number which is to the right side is greater. Now, you have to write 0 is greater than minus 4 by 7. And the final number is 2 by 7 is greater than all these three. Thank you.